even the environment. Ever as I walk, I try to absorb these characteristics of God, or the characteristics of God revealed to us through nature. One time I was very sick. I was bleeding for 1 week. And I went to the doctors and they said, "Father, you have cancer." That word, cancer, scared me to death, because my father and other members of the family died of cancer. I know what it means to have cancer. And so what I did was I resigned from Bishop Alam, from Occidental Mindoro, to went back to Malaysia and started the process of healing myself through prayer, through exercise, but especially through walking. Walking to the mountains and under the trees to inhale and exhale, like the Buddhists are doing, or have taught us, or taught me at least. And as I inhale and exhale, I try to inhale the good energy coming from the cosmos, coming from the environment. And as I exhale the things that are destroying my health. After 1 month of religiously doing that, I went to the U.S. for medical check. Just as three doctors in the Philippines told me that I had cancer, three doctors in the U.S. examined me and said, "Nothing wrong with you." What healed me, of course, God, through prayer, the Christian way, and the Buddhist way. Towards a missionary catechesis. Catechesis has always been missionary. It is not instructional, it is not doctrine. Since the beginning, it was always a missionary catechesis. And so when Monsignor Jerry invited me, my mind went back to the classroom at the Gregorian University in Rome. My mind went back to Father Joseph Shi from China. May he rest in peace. He taught us visionary catechesis. And so what I would share with you this morning is something that is important for us to consider in the Philippine context. First, religion and culture are, or can also be, sources of peace and harmony. Meaning to say that part of our work of doing catechesis is to share our experiences of interculturality and interreligiosity. Cultures can divide, religions can divide, but they can also be sources of peace and harmony. Second, missionary catechesis has to be inclusivist. Meaning to say, if we talk about God, or if we talk about Jesus Christ, we must also talk about, or Christianity, we must also talk about other religions. In New Zealand, where I was also assigned, at the elementary level, the students are already studying world religions. Why? Because New Zealand is a country that is open to all kinds of people, irregardless of their religious background or race. So already in the elementary level, they are teaching the children world religions in addition to Christianity. Third, catechesis can help us build a church of dialogue. We always say that dialogue is the way of doing mission. in the Philippines, according to PCP 2, dialogue is more than doing mission. It is also the new way of being church. So, to do that, we must build a church of dialogue. A church that is always open to the other. That is why today also, interfaith dialogue is becoming more and more urgent in that important. So is ecumenism. I teach ecumenism in four schools. I wonder if four schools of theology. I wonder if these are taught also in other schools of theology in the Philippines. Finally, catechesis can build a church that is dissociated from the world. Meaning to say, as we build up the Philippine church, we should not forget that the Philippine church is also a part of the Asian church and the universal church. In the past, the formula was back to Rome. Later on, back to Christ, and today, back to God. We must all go back to God. As Christians, of course, as Christians, going back to God. As Buddhists, going back to God. As Hindus, going back to God. I like to conclude my reflection, and allow me to read what I wrote down here. Ancient Christians, meaning also Filipino Christians, through their bishops, are singing their songs in their own tunes. The triple dialogue of the FABC has signaled the Pentecost in Asia. It has led them to return to the pluralism of earliest Christian tradition, consonant with the Asian cultural ethics. The triple dialogues gives place to the pluralism of Pentecost, Acts chapter 2, 1 to 12, and the multiculturality of Babel, Genesis 11. Asians have to carry forward the legacy of Vatican II in a living manner, in a multi-religious and pluricultural country. This is a big challenge, but it makes Christian life in Asia exciting as well. Shalom.